Hello students, let us continue with the chapter Refraction Through Lens. That is chapter number 5 and this is video number 21, part 2. So in the last video we were doing the rules how to construct a ray diagram for a lens. So students, this construction of ray diagram for a lens is given. Just whenever you are asked to draw a ray diagram, just follow the two rules only. Just follow the two rules and automatically you will get the image of the object. Few things which you have to keep in mind while drawing the ray diagram. Object is always placed above the principal axis. First thing, object is always placed above the principal axis, and then from the top of the object you have to take the two rays of light. You can take two only, so any two ray of light you can take and follow the rules. And wherever that two, after refraction, the two rays intersect each other, it means at that point the image of the object will formed. Even this we have done in 9th standard also. So let us discuss first when the object is at infinity. When the object is at infinity means u is equal to infinity. So first of all, what is u? U is the distance of the object. U, distance of the object, distance of the object from the optical center. From the optical center. Now v is the distance of the image, distance of the image of the object from the optical center. And f is the focal length, means from the optical center, the distance between the focus and the optical center, that is known as focal length. So students, when the object is at infinity, the image is formed at the focus, and the characteristics of the image formed is real, inverted and diminished. Real, inverted and diminished almost to a point. Then if the object is as a far distance, means u is very very larger than the f, focal length, then here again two rules are followed. One rule is followed, when the ray of light passes through the optical center, it will go undeviately. Another rule is followed, when the ray of light passing through the focus after refraction, it becomes parallel. So wherever these two rays will intersect means the image will formed. Now what are the characteristics of the image formed here? The characteristics of the image forms are real, inverted and highly diminished. Now the application of this, in this manner a convex lens is used as a varnishing glass or camera lens. To use the convex lens as a varnishing glass, the ray of light from the sun infinity are brought to focus on a piece of paper kept in the second focal plane of the lens. So what I want to tell you that whenever the distance of the object is given, so whenever the distance of the object is given, first draw the diagram. So in this case, the object is placed beyond 2F. So the image is forming between 2F2 and F2. Now the characteristics of the image: real, inverted and diminished. So application, a convex lens is used in this manner as a camera lens when the object not very far is to be photographed. So like this, you have to learn the characteristics as well as the application. Now this is one of the important case when the object is placed between the optical center and the focus. So in other cases, the image formed was real, inverted. But in this case, when the object is placed between the optical center and the focus, the image formed is virtual. Virtual, erect, upright and magnified. So in this manner, a convex lens is used as a reading lens. Is that a magnifying glass or simple microscope? Or another word you can say, it is in case of simple microscope. So like this, you have to draw the diagram, you have to learn the characteristics of the image formed and the applications also. Now next, it is a case of concave lens when the object is at infinity. Again, you follow the rule, the ray parallel, after refraction it diverts and it appears to meet at the focus. So when the object is at infinity, so the image is formed at the focus. So then next, if the object is at a far distance on the principal axis, so like this, again the ray of light is coming and after refraction it becomes parallel, it appears to pass to the focus. This is one of the rules. Second rule they have followed, the ray of light is passing undeviatedly through the optical center. Now these two rays are intersecting here, so when the object is at infinity, the image formed is at the focus. Then the characteristics of the image: virtual, erect, highly diminished. A concave lens is used in Galilean telescope in this manner. So in other case, wherever you will place the object, the image in case of this concave lens will always form between the optical center and the focus. It is virtual, erect and diminished wherever you will place, except these two cases, one infinity, another is when the object is at very large distance. But rest of the cases, the image will always form between the optical center and the focus. So the characteristics of the image will be virtual, erect and diminished. Now a concave lens application. A concave lens is used in spectacles for the short-sighted person in this manner. Now even you can go through this blueprint, then next topic, this topic is deleted, sign convention and lens formula. Linear magnification is not there. Now the power of lens topic is there, power of a lens. So here I have written What is power of lens? Power of lens is the reciprocal of focal length. Means power is equal to 1 by f in meter. So the SI unit of power is that. Here I am writing SI unit of power of lens is diopter, DIOPTRE, and the symbol is D. So SI unit of power of lens is diopter, that is a symbol is D. Now the power of the convex lens is positive because after refraction the ray of light converge, and the power of concave lens is negative because after the refraction the ray of light diverges and appears to meet at the focus. So this is what power is. Now the next topic is application of lenses. This topic is there, application of lenses. Lenses are used in large number of optical instruments. Some common applications are below. Just go through all this, and from any one of the application the question can be asked to you. You must go through it, go through all. 7 applications are given, you must go through it. And next topic is not there. So with this chapter is finished, and I will take your doubts in the online classes. So with this chapter is finished. Let us move to the next chapter, that is current electricity. Thank you very much.